اطلب العلم أخي فهو درب به نور، به ترقى به تحيا عالما حرا فخور.
اطلب العلم أخي فهو درب به نور، به ترقى به تحيا عالما حرا فخور.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله وكفى، وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على عباده الذين اصطفى، وبعد. After Musa alayhi salam, Allah appointed a Nabi, a prophet. Who was that prophet? A lot of the ulama are of the opinion that it was the young boy who accompanied him when they went to meet Al-Khidr. There was a young boy who was holding the bag with a fish. His name was Yusha ibn Nun. In the English language, Joshua, may peace be upon him.
He took on the leadership after Musa alayhi salam, and that was coming to the end of the 40-year punishment. And after that 40 years, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala once again, He promised Bani Israel to enter Ilya, Jerusalem, and Allah will give them victory over the people who are living in Ilya, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will bless them to live in Jerusalem. None of the people who worshipped the calf were living at the time of Yusha. So Yusha had better generation than the generation that Musa alayhi salam had. I'm not saying they were good, I'm saying they were better. So they were the best of the worst. And then it came. Yusha alayhi salam with that new generation fighting in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So one of the laws that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala had ordained them is the day of Sarray. Sarray is a day in which they're not allowed to work in. Jihad is also forbidden on them during Sarray. Saturday is the holy day. And Yusha alayhi salam with Bani Israel fighting in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala throughout the week until Friday. And we know that the night begins before the day. When Sarray comes, it's the day that they have to stop. So Friday afternoon, the sun is setting, Sarray is coming, and it's a day for them to stop. So here, Yusha alayhi salam is fighting in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Bani Israel is behind him, fighting on Friday day till Friday afternoon came. All they need is an extra more time for them to demolish the enemy. And the sun is setting. Once the sun sets, it's Sarray. Once Sarray comes, they have to stop. Problem. Very big problem. Could you imagine you are just arriving to the last point and then you have to stop? So Yusha alayhi salam, he looked at the sun and he said, "You are ordered by Allah and I am ordered by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Oh Allah, make the sun stop and be paused for me." So Allah paused the sun for Yusha alayhi salam to continue fighting in the path of Allah until Allah gave him victory. That's when the sun set. The sun was not paused for any human being except for Yusha. Allahu Akbar, a victory for Bani Israel after so many years of humiliation. Now Bani Israel received the first honor in a very long time. And now Allah honored them by opening a new place for them, a sacred place, a place called Jerusalem. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, "And when we told you, enter this town and live in this town and ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for His forgiveness in return for what Allah had given you in this town. When you enter that town, say, Hitta, it means, oh Allah, forgive us. And then enter this town, walking, enter this town, prostrating to Allah. Thank Allah for what Allah had given you. Allah had given you victory when you don't even deserve it. Allah had given you victory when you were outnumbered. Allah had given you victory when they were much stronger than you. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave you victory. In return, enter that town, prostrating to Allah. Make sujood to Allah, thanking Him. And ask Allah for His forgiveness by saying, Hitta. And Allah will increase from the good that He had given you. So what did they do? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, those who had oppressed on themselves, they exchanged what Allah had ordered them to say. Instead of them walking in and saying, Hitta, oh Allah, forgive us, they were mocking what Allah was saying. They were saying, Hidda, Hinta. Hinta means seeds of wheat. And they were mocking, laughing. And instead of them walking in, prostrating to Allah, thanking Allah for what had given them, they were walking on their butts. They were dragging themselves on their butts, entering the town, making fun of what Allah Azza wa Jalla had ordered them. Subhanallah. Don't you people understand? Allah Azza wa Jalla had given you victory in front of your eyes. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made a miracle with no prophet before you, after you had received. And Allah had paused the sun for you, so Sarray does not enter, and for you to continue your fighting on the day of Friday. And here you are in return. Instead of you saying, "Ya Allah, we thank you for what you had given us, and we prostrate to you to humiliate and humble ourselves to you, and say, Ya Allah, forgive our sins." You mock what Allah had ordered you to say. Instead of you walking in prostrating, you walk on your butts, dragging it into the town. And instead of you saying, "Oh Allah, forgive us, hitta," you say hanta, you say hinta, making fun of what the Prophet Yusha alayhi salam had ordered you to say, mocking your own prophet. So what did Allah do in return? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, "We sent on them a punishment from the heavens." Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala spread the sickness and disease among them. They were hit with a plague. 20,000 of them died in one day.
And there were certain people who tried to flee from the plague. They ran away from that plague and they were in their thousands. أَلَمْ تَرَ إِلَى الَّذِينَ خَرَجُوا مِن دِيَارِهِمْ وَهُمْ أُلُوفٌ حَذَرَ الْمَوْتِ. Do you see those who ran away in their thousands fearing death? Because there was a plague where they were, so they were fearing death and they ran away. Where did they go? The top of the mountain, a plateau. And they settled there for a while. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala instructed the angel of death to cause their death. فَقَالَ لَهُمُ اللَّهُ مُوتُ. Allah told them, all of them should die.
Yusha alayhi salam lived until he was 127 years old. And the scholars say that was 27 years after the death of Musa alayhi salam.
Hizkeel was passing this place and he'd seen a town which seemed like there was nothing wrong with it. No punishment had overcome it. There was no one there besides some bones. But the destruction, how did it come? Everybody died all at once. And as he was watching, Allah says, and this is in a narration, obviously this is now a Hebrew narration, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala asked him, "Would you like to see these people come back to life?" And indeed, he wanted to see it. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, ثُمَّ أَحْيَاهُمْ إِنَّ اللَّهَ لَذُو فَضْلٍ عَلَى النَّاسِ وَلَكِنَّ أَكْثَرَ النَّاسِ لَا يَشْكُرُونَ. And then Allah gave them life. And this man was watching. He's seeing the bones come together. He's seeing how thereafter the flesh is coming on the bones. And the people were back. And they started walking and everything back to their day-to-day lives as though nothing had happened. And Allah says, Allah is very, very bountiful upon people. He bestows them with so many gifts, but many people are not grateful. Until we meet again, wa sallallahu wa sallam wa baraka ala nabina Muhammad. Subhanallah bihamdihi, subhanakallahumma bihamdik. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, nastaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk.